Hello friends, it's a pleasure to have you back to my channel today. This week I'll be talking to you about the causes of epilepsy. In my last video, I tried to introduce what epilepsy is, so I refer you to it in case you missed that video. Before I start, I'd like to welcome the first timers and indeed returning viewers. This is Brain Gist, where we enlighten people about the brain and its disorders, and we give guidance as to what you should do in case you have any of those disorders or know someone close to you who've got some of those disorders. So I encourage you to subscribe so you can take full advantage of all that this channel has got to offer. So today we're talking about the causes of epilepsy. Broadly speaking, I would divide the causes of epilepsy into three groups. The first group are genetic causes, and the second group are those situations in which they raise an identifiable insult to the brain that leads to seizures with an enduring tendency, and that's epilepsy. And the third group are those in whom there is no identifiable cause for their seizures. Today, I'll be focusing on just one group, and then hopefully I'll do a follow-up video where I will discuss the remaining two categories. So today, I'll be talking about those epilepsies that are due to an identifiable insult to the brain. So the bottom line for this category is that there is an identifiable insult to the brain, either remotely, that means in the past, in a very long period of time, there has been some insult, or there is an ongoing insult to the brain at the moment. So it starts from the time, the prenatal life or prenatal time, when the baby is yet to be born. So the first 8 weeks, the entire period of pregnancy is a vulnerability period or a vulnerable period. However, I would say the first 8 weeks is very, very cardinal. So sometimes the mothers have contracted some infections during this period that crossed over to their babies, and that could cause the babies to develop epilepsy shortly after delivery or even later in childhood. Or sometimes they've taken some medications that potentially cross over and insult the developing brain. So it's always important when you're pregnant to make sure that before taking any medications, you discuss with your doctor, your gynecologist. And then now in the during delivery itself, sometimes if the birth process or the labor process is difficult and prolonged, that can be a risk factor for that epilepsy that can cause significant injury to the brain of a newborn, and that can cause seizures or epilepsy in the future. And then as the individual grows up, if there is trauma to the head or to the brain, that can cause injury to the brain and cause seizures in the short term or in the long term. Now, let's think about infections in and around the brain, like meningitis or encephalitis. This can cause seizures while the infection is going on. And even after the infection is cleared in those who survive, that could leave a lasting impact or a lasting scarring, so to speak, within the brain. And that can make that brain vulnerable to generating seizures, and that's epilepsy. Even stroke can cause seizures in the short term, and after the individual must have recovered, they can develop epilepsy. Brain tumor can cause the same thing. So basically anything at all that insults the brain can cause that. And if we move away from the brain, or before I leave that, head trauma is also very important. So sometimes some people have had a road traffic accident or falling from heights and traumatized their heads and gone unconscious. That can cause seizures both in the short term and in the long term. And if we look at the body as a whole, because the brain is part of the body and the body functions as a single integrated system. So if you've got anything wrong with the entire bodily system that can disturb the brain and cause seizures, probably in the short term. It may not be in the long term. For example, someone who's got COVID, they could have a seizure. Someone who's been fasting for so long a time could have a seizure because their glucose levels have dropped or their certain salt levels have dropped, and that puts them at risk of a seizure. That may not be enduring if identified and corrected very quickly. So in this short video, I hope I've been able to enlighten you about just one of the three main groups of the causes of epilepsy. And I hope to, you know, do the remaining courses in my follow-up video. So I encourage you to subscribe and stay tuned so you can learn more from it. So if you learned something today, I'd like you to give a video a thumbs up, share the video, and don't forget to subscribe and also leave your comments. Do you think some of the things I've talked about relates to you or to someone you know? Please leave your comments and we can have a nice discussion afterwards. So let me seize this opportunity to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year ahead. Thank you so much for watching, and I see you in my next video. Till then, goodbye and stay safe.